The following is part of a collection of interviews conducted by El Grupo Elron, a non-profit group dedicated to eradicating false concepts in all fields of knowledge through the teachings of the Ascended Masters of Light, by a medium, Jorge Raúl Holguín. November 7th, 2007. Messages from the Solar Logos. Master Jesus.
Dear friends, dear brothers, confidently I say to you that everything which is conceptualized in the spiritual realm can also be thought on the physical plane. Truly, I say unto you, dear brothers, that what we conceptualize here in the spiritual planes causes so much pain when we see that many beings on the physical plane are immersed in doubts and questions even for themselves. In truth, I tell you, dear friends, not even I am perfect, because my Father made me with roles of ego just like all of you. And truly, I say to you, as I said 2,000 years ago, do not look at the speck of sawdust in your neighbor's eye, but pay attention to the beam in our own eye, because each one of us, in some way, in one of our incarnations, have made mistakes, and I don't deny it, because I was also possessed by the ego, more than once, and I panicked and I had pain and uncertainty. And I had doubts, until the strong part of my spirit overcame that and began to see the other person's pain, and I stopped thinking about my pain. However, dear friends, if I, to whom many of you call your Lord, had doubts, why wouldn't you all have to have them? If I had uncertainties, why wouldn't you have to have them? If I struggled with my own ego, crying at nights, wondering if the message I was giving was true, why wouldn't you be ashamed to mourn? Do you know how many times I felt alienated, lonely, misunderstood, and out of place? Do you know, dear brethren, the times that being in company, talking, eating lamb and drinking wine, while on the inside, I had a lump in the throat and I could not swallow due to the anguish I felt for not feeling myself fully understood? Seeing the beings around me laughing and merrymaking, and I was laughing with them, but deep inside me, I was thinking, will they understand what I mean? Will they understand my true message? If I didn't feel understood, do not be ashamed if you do not feel understood. If I was in solitude many times, do not be afraid if you feel yourself alone. 1 out of 100 people might understand you, 1 of 100. I don't even know if 1 of 100 would understand me now. My dear John, who praised me so much, used to lean on my shoulder while I was speaking big words, and he used to stare at me with love, but then when I stopped talking, looked at his eyes and said to him, did you understand what I told you? Master, whatever you say is fine. No. No. You have to understand, because when I'm gone you'll remain. When I'm gone you will continue. Because Simon told me once, what about this man? And I said to Simon more than once, leave him because he'll remain when I'm gone. But I told John, you're only 16 years old and I know that you don't understand many things, but I have little time on this plane. In less than 2 years I will not be here. So, I don't want you to look at me only with devotion, I want you to pay attention, otherwise I'll feel lonelier. And sometimes not even the one who loved me the most understood me in that life. The worst thing is feeling sorry for ourselves or feeling sorrow for ourselves, because everyone is important. You call me your Lord. I am not more important than you are. I can be important in the fact that I transcended, and for many that have transcended, it's as if they are carried away by the echo, because the human being is like an echo, for that reason they hear me. However, nobody owns the absolute truth, not even me. Truly, humbly I say to you, it's not bad to doubt oneself, it's not bad to question ourselves, and it's not bad to feel different from others at times, because I've felt different from others. Not better or worse, but different. And in each era, there is a society that leaves its mark on you. It's true. And verily, I say that we must not follow the herd blindly, otherwise we might fall into the devotion of John, who loved me, but I don't want that, because love becomes blind. That John, from 2,000 years ago, at 16 years of age, began to understand the message, because I told him, things are reasoned out. But dear master, he told me love does not reason, love is felt. Yes, love is felt. But then you have to explain behaviors that come from love. Then you have to explain how to transmute that love into action, and there you need understanding, you're just a growing child. Yes, I have felt lonely, but I had the courage to face what was coming next. And I praise those who supported me. For that reason I vouch for John, because John was with me when I was left alone, he and my biological mother. He didn't pull away. Fear could not be more than love was. That's why I praise John so much, and truly, I say that love is stronger than fear, love is stronger than hatred, and love is stronger than the roles of the ego. Do not try to stand out just for the fact to stand out, because you are a shell. The important thing, what is worthwhile, is inside, the inner light, the spirit. Everything else is temporary. You all quarrel about a piece of bread instead of sharing it. It's true that if any among you, who take a cut out from the other, commits a hostile act, and that should be put on the table. Share, do not monopolize. Do not make up excuses, because all fictional excuses are also hostile acts. One of the biggest mistakes is to believe that a certain goal cannot be achieved. And truly I say unto you, you and this vessel, that we all can achieve the same goals. Everyone. The issue is how to walk the path. How do you want to walk the path? The path towards the light must be traveled with one's head held high, because you all are important, because you all are worthwhile, because you all are useful. Chance. Truly, I say to you that there will always be people who will put obstacles in your path, but the obstacles are to overcome, not to stop us. And I use myself as an example. In the 2 years and 3 months that my campaign lasted, I had dozens, I had hundreds of obstacles and criticism. For that reason, without being repetitive, I appreciate those who supported me unconditionally. Because in them I can trust. Not the ones who doubted. And that's one of the things I taught John. And when Simon said the last time, "And what about this man or that man?" You take care of yourself. You spread the word. This, John, will go on as the comforting spirit, and he will embody again and transmit my word. However, it's necessary that today, in this present, everyone knows his ability. Because it's true, we are not a carbon copy of each other. As you say in your jargon, clones. You all have the same opportunities. You will tell me, no. Because some of us were born in different regions, different families, different situations, disrupted economies. How can you say, master, that we all have the same opportunities? And I answer, I transcended. And more than one person asked me, why did you decide to embody in the unknown Bethlehem and not in Rome, where you would have transcended much more? And before I leave, I'll ask you all, would I have transcended more, or didn't I transcend from that unknown place? Then let's not look for an excuse to say, I can't do it, I can't reach it because that goal is far away, I won't ever do it, or I'm not worthy. I don't allow those words. You are truly my brothers and dear friends. If I tell you I love you all so much that my heart breaks. Love yourselves, be worthy of yourselves. I always teach to look after your neighbor, but look after yourselves first. The dear John, who is embodied in this vessel, said a long time ago, loving your neighbor as yourself means that in order to love your neighbor, you have to love yourself first. Love your neighbor as yourself, but first you have to love yourself. I send all my light to you. So long.